tips for elk hunting. Elk looking is each hunter's dream to be ready to leave and shoot a monster bull. Some hunters have the luck of doing it per annum, except for those that have that one lifetime likelihood to travel alces looking. Here are a couple of tips that may assist you on your hunt. Even if you are going to be using a guide, at least you will have the heads up a little bit. First, which your guide should or already knows that hunting in thick cover will help your chances of shooting that monster elk. You can glass for alces on open hillsides, since most likely you will see an elk, especially cows and young bulls. But seeing some of the best sightings can be done under thick cover. You're thinking, how in the world am I going to spot an elk in thick cover? Well, don't worry about that, you will see them. They aren't the smallest animal in the world, and plus it helps keep you hidden from them as well. Second, you want to be in shape. I know this sounds silly, but you have to remember you could be walking for miles before you spot or even see an elk. You have to be ready to hike up, down, over blowdowns, carry a heavy pack, and be able to run when you need to. Remember, if you do shot an elk, who do you think is going to carry it back to camp for you? Yup, that's right, it will be just you and your guide if you have one. That can make you very tired quickly. Third, you want to pay attention to the wind. Just like you, the other hunt you'd get on, elk hunting wouldn't be any different. If you're looking with a guide, they'll have the simplest positions for being downwind that the elk, European alces, moose, alces, deer, cervid, will not smell you, and ups your probabilities of shooting that monster elk. But if you are hunting with just your buddy, you want to make sure you go that extra mile to approach an area that is downwind. You always ought to listen to the wind, whereas out looking, because the wind will amendment direction in a very blank of an eye fixed, and you'll have to find another spot that is downwind. Fourth, looking within the afternoon and staying till dark. Some hunters head into the woods early and leave at midday, and some will say you are leaving right when things are going to be getting in their prime for the evening. Staying in till middle afternoon can assist you within the long-standing time, as you can get a good meal in you to give you energy for the long hike ahead of you, and you are going out when the animals are starting to get ready to settle down for the night and won't have their guard up. Finally, make sure to slow down. You don't need to run to your spot, as you would possibly miss one thing like that monster alces you're trying to find. Trying hiking a mile about and take a glance around to visualize what's out there, or to form certain you will not be running into any cows or young bulls on your way to where the big bulls are. Plus, taking some time can prevent some energy rather than burning it all off quickly. All these tips are going to be useful if looking alces by yourself or pal, or looking with a guide. Make sure you have everything you need to go on the hunt, and be patient enough for that monster bull to step out and give you that perfect shot.